guilty on all three counts. That is the jury's verdict this afternoon in the high-profile Highway 169 road rage murder trial. Jamal Smith will now receive an automatic life sentence for first-degree murder in the death of youth baseball coach Jay Boughton. Lou Ragus was there for the entire trial. He joins us now live from the Hennepin County Courthouse in Minneapolis. Lou?
Well, Lauren, it was a very emotional time here for Jay Boughton's family and all the supporters here at the Hennepin County Government Center. It's been years since this many spectators have been here every day for a trial.
Wearing yellow to the courthouse, the family of Jay Boughton wanted to represent staying in the light.
What does that leave for Harrison, who witnessed this? If I went to anger, I chose not to do that. This has always been about staying in the light.
Kristen Robinson Boughton's son Harrison was with his dad on their way home from a baseball game when they encountered Jamal Smith on Highway 169, speeding and trying to force his way into their lane. Harrison testified that Jay honked the horn and gave Smith the finger. Then Jay was killed by a single shot. Prosecutors showed the traffic footage that showed Smith slow down, they say, to line up that shot. And they say gunshot residue proved the shot came from the driver's seat. Video he posted himself showed Smith holding the kind of gun that killed Jay. But Smith testified that his backseat passenger was the shooter. His story verged on ludicrous at times, such as claiming at first he thought the gunshot was thunder.
We wanted the truth to come out. And today, the jury found Evil guilty on all three counts.
The Boughton family has somehow stayed out of anger. In the light, Kristen saying they have a long way to go without Jay.
My children, Harrison and Amelie, have strength and courage. They keep me going. I want to thank so many people for their thoughts and prayers.
Now, those two other passengers who were with Smith have not been charged in this case and could not be found for this trial. That life sentence that Jamal Smith will now serve in prison, he will be eligible for parole after serving at least 30 years of it. Back to you.
All right, Lou, thank you.